HarperCollins presents The Nature Remedy by Faith Douglas. Read by Kristin Atherton. Those who contemplate the beauty of the earth find reserves of strength that will endure as long as life lasts. Rachel Carson, author and conservationist. Introduction. Over many years, my work has convinced me of one fundamental truth. Without nature, we wouldn't survive. Yet without us, nature would thrive. This belief has become my mantra, and it's an approach that I think everyone should take the time to consider deeply. Today, the importance of our human connection to nature is my driving passion, and it's what keeps me sane in this chaotic, complicated world of ours. After all, nature, quite literally, saved my life. My story. I began my career in nursing, but 13 years of caring for people in a medical environment eventually took its toll on me. I often took my work home, emotionally, which had a knock-on effect on my physical and mental health. However, I was lucky enough to live within walking distance of the countryside, and I often found solace in the local woodlands. I also loved spending time in my garden, and became particularly interested in growing herbs for their healing benefits. Perhaps not surprisingly, I was encouraged by friends and family to change my career. However, I had small children at the time, and I struggled to believe that I could do anything other than what I did. Somehow, I plucked up the confidence to enroll in college to study horticulture, and afterwards landed a job as an instructor for a wonderful charity called Horticap. It offered me a role that was the perfect combination of my nursing experience and knowledge of plants. In 2009, my family and I moved to live in a rural environment that just so happened to have an arboretum on its doorstep, an incredible botanical garden devoted to a collection of trees that were gathered from all around the world. At the time, I didn't really know what an arboretum was, so I suppose you could say this is where fate stepped in. When I was out walking my dogs over nearby fields, I happened to bump into a fellow dog walker. We got chatting, and he asked me what I did. When I explained, he mentioned that his father owned the arboretum and said I should drop off my CV. Now, I must tell you that at the time, I was pregnant with my youngest son and in a job that I absolutely loved, so I really wasn't looking for a change. So I promptly forgot about the conversation. But the universe was insistent. Fast forward a couple of months, and I was up to my neck in dust from sanding the nursery floor when there was a knock at the front door. I opened it to see a man who introduced himself with a smile and who I later learned was Sir John Ropner, owner of the Thorpe Perro Arboretum and Bird of Prey and Mammal Centre. He told me he had heard I was good at my job, then promptly walked me down the street to meet his wife, who was bravely lying flat in the back of the Land Rover, having broken her knee the day before. I will never, ever forget that moment as long as I live. It was so surreal. When they asked me if I would come to the arboretum to discuss a job vacancy that had come up, I found myself agreeing. A week after knocking at the door of Thorpe Perro, I was offered the role of curator of the arboretum. I haven't looked back since. It marked the start of my personal journey into how humans can gain support, boost their health, and improve their quality of life through their connection with nature. It has been life-changing. Discovering the healing power of nature. Somewhere along the way, I found myself going through a very difficult time. I was trying to manage my professional life and my family life, and at the same time, I was experiencing domestic abuse. I didn't really realise it was domestic abuse at first, or that it could be happening to me. But it did happen, and it can happen to anyone. The most important thing is that I got out. I survived. And I feel I have the natural world to thank for my resilience and recovery. After ending the relationship, I was continually stalked and terrorised for a number of months. Eventually, with help from the police and IDAS, Independent Domestic Abuse Services, my abuser was imprisoned and protections were put in place to keep me safe. However, the fear had been incredibly real and overwhelming. I was also working with the charity Help for Heroes at the time, and this experience, combined with my nursing background, meant I was all too aware of the signs that I had developed post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD. I knew what I needed to do. I threw myself into my work and took sanctuary in my home and surrounding countryside. I practiced mindfulness and experienced firsthand the benefits that a natural environment can have on somebody's emotional, mental, and physical health. At some point during this time, the term forest bathing appeared in my life. There was little information available about this practice back then, which had roots in Japan, so I started to do some research into it. The practice made sense and came naturally to me. It clearly worked. And the great thing was that science backed up everything I was experiencing. I started to share the benefits of forest bathing with other people. I set up forestbathing.uk, as there was nothing else like it at the time in Britain, and I wanted to show people just how easy and obvious this stuff was, and to enable people to take responsibility for their own well-being. I now run retreats, workshops and walks for people from many different backgrounds, young and old, all around the country. Everyone can improve their lives using nature. It's fun, it's free, and it's easy. You'll hear more about forest bathing later on. Natural precepts to live by. The more people I meet, the more individuals I come across who are crying out for a connection with the natural world. Today, society is in many ways dangerously disconnected. People are separate both from each other and their surroundings. Mental health problems and stress are on the rise for children and adults. We need nature. We are part of it. And the sooner we embrace the natural element in our lives, sooner balance will be restored in our lives. Ultimately, I believe this will lead to balance in the environment itself. Today, I live by a number of precepts, which have given my own life calm and meaning. Why not bring these into your life too, and see what magic happens? Go out into nature every day. This could be a walk in the park, or the walk to work. It could just mean stepping outside your front door or opening your window to breathe. Simply allow yourself to be in nature. Every day, be mindful in nature. Switch on your senses, listen, and look at your surroundings. Let everything else melt away and feel that relief, even if just for a moment. Every day, say thank you to nature. To have gratitude for something to which we are so deeply connected brings an appreciation for all life like no other. Have faith in nature and make nature a habit. The nature of this book. This book builds upon these key precepts in 5 chapters. The subject in each chapter is enormous in scope and could potentially fill whole libraries, So I've focused on topics that I hope will tickle your curiosity and encourage you to find out more about those areas that interest you. Throughout this book, you will find tips, exercises, journaling prompts, and suggestions for ways to enjoy an urban detox that will enhance your connection with the natural world. Feel free to experiment. What works for one person won't necessarily work for another. Nature is fluid, changing effortlessly, and accepting what is without judgment. So if you follow this approach, you won't go far wrong. If you listen to the Nature Remedy many times over, something different could resonate with you when it is most needed. Or you could simply dip into it anytime you need a reminder of your connection with nature, or some respite from your daily worries. 21 Days of Nature. Why not make nature a healthy habit? We spend so much of our lives developing habits and behaviours by repeatedly carrying out the same tasks day in and day out. Keep a note of your connection in nature for 21 days and see what happens. See how quickly it becomes a natural part of your everyday life. Journaling. Journaling is an ancient technique that is probably as old as handwriting itself. The ancient Japanese journaled some 2,000 years ago. Today, many people continue to find journaling immensely therapeutic. It's a process that allows you to express all your thoughts and feelings without judgment and can provide a great sense of release. Journaling has so many benefits. It encourages a state of mindfulness, is a great stress reliever, can help you to achieve your goals, boosts confidence and memory, encourages creativity. Throughout this book, you will come across journal prompts, and I would strongly encourage you to write down your thoughts, views, and feelings in response to them. Buy or make a beautiful nature journal. Doodle and draw, or stick things in it. Make it your own personal journey through the wonders of the natural world, and see where it takes you. Remedy. A natural reminder. Many years ago, I cut a ribbon from a book to wear on my wrist as a reminder of the importance of calm. When the ribbon wore thin, I replaced it with another, then another. And along with keeping the copy of that book on my shelves, I still wear a ribbon reminder on my wrist today. While there is no ribbon in this audiobook, it's easy to make one of your own. Then, when you reach the end of this audiobook, you can either tie it around your wrist as a daily reminder of your connection to nature, or place it in a picture frame and hang it where you will see it every day. Gather at least 8 long blades of fresh grass, the sturdy kind that grow in hedgerows, or ornamentally are good options, and soak them in warm water to make the grass easier to work with. Gather the blades together and tie a knot to secure them at one end. Placing the knot at the top, secure the knot with a pin in a cork board or something similar to make it easier to weave. Divide the blades into 4 sections, with 2 blades in each section. Pick up the first section on the left, weave it up and over towards the right, until this section becomes the last section on the right. Repeat with each section on the left, weaving it over to the right and feeding in more grass as necessary, tightening it into place until the bookmark is the desired length. Check the finished result fits around your wrist, then tie the end to the initial knot to create a loop for your wrist. Or simply tie a knot in the end to create one long woven bookmark. You can trim any loose ends with scissors or attach a wooden bead to finish, securing with a knot. Journal prompts. How aware are you of nature in your life?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.